Good afternoon, all the students. Today, let us discuss some more applications which were given in previous IIT examinations based on our electromagnetic induction lesson. So let us see one application which was asked in JEE Main 2013. JEE Main 2013. The question is like this. As per the question, a circular loop of radius 0.3 centimeters lies parallel to a much bigger circular loop. Of radius 20 centimeters. The center of the smaller loop is on the axis of the bigger loop. The center of the smaller loop is on the axis of bigger loop. The distance between the centers is the distance between the centers is 15 centimeters. If current of 2 amperes flows through the smaller loop, then the flux linked with the bigger loop is this is the question given to us. Solution. So as per the question, the two loops are oriented like this. This is a smaller loop. This is a bigger loop. Both are having centers on the same axis. The radius of smaller loop is 0.3 centimeters. Radius of bigger loop is 20 centimeters. Their centers are separated by 15 centimeters distance. And current passing through the smaller loop is 2 amperes. Then the flux linked with the bigger loop. What is the flux linked here? This is the question mark. You know that whenever current is passing through a loop, it generates some magnetic field. Magnetic field due to a circular current carrying loop on its axial point is given by a formula mu 0 ni a square by 2 into a square plus x square whole power 3 pi, where a is the radius of the loop, n is the number of turns in the loop, x is the distance of the point at which we would like to find the strength of the magnetic field. Here number of turns is 1. Radius a is given as 0.3 centimeters. But answer they gave in Weber's. Answer they gave in Weber's. So that's why I would like to convert this centimeters into meters, 0.3 into 10 power minus 2 meters. So the strength of the magnetic field B is equal to mu naught 4 pi into 10 power minus 7. Number of turns is 1. Current passing through it is 2 amperes. A square, that is 0.3 into 10 power minus 2 whole square by 2 into A square, 0.3 into 10 power minus 2 whole square plus x square. X is the distance, 15 centimeters, that is 15 into 10 power minus 2 meters. So 15 into 10 power minus 2 whole square whole power 3 by 2. This is the value of magnetic induction field at a distance 15 centimeters from the center of the loop. So on simplification of this, you will get the strength of the field here. Whenever you want flux, flux is defined as B bar dot A bar, B A cos theta. So magnetic field strength is in this direction. A bar will also be in the same direction, cos 0 is 1. So the flux is given by BA. Flux is given by BA. A means area of the loop you considered here. So this 2 and 2 gets cancelled. So you are left with 4 pi into 10 power minus 7 into, you can write it as, you can write it as, area of the loop is given by pi r square. Pi into radius of the bigger loop is 20 centimeters, that is 20 into 10 power minus 2 whole square. So this B value you should take from here. 1 minute. On simplification of this, B value you should take from here, pi into r square. This is the general formula. So here 4 pi into 0.09 into 10 power minus 4 minus 11, it becomes by, again it is 0.09 plus 15 are 225. So 225.0.09 into 10 power minus 4 whole power 3 by 2 into pi into radius of this loop square, 20 into 10 power minus 2 whole square. So on simplification of this, you will get the phi value. The phi value is given by 9.2 into 10 power minus 11 webers. This is the solution for the given question. This is the solution for the given question. One more question. AEEE 2012. Here the question is like this. A coil is suspended in uniform magnetic field. A coil is suspended in uniform magnetic field with the plane of the coil parallel to magnetic lines of force. When the current is passed through the coil, it starts oscillating. It is very difficult to stop. But if an aluminium plate is placed, nearer to the coil, it stops. This is due to, this is the question. The options, it's a theory based question. The options they gave like this: development of air current when the plate is placed. This is the first option. Second option, induction of electrical charge on the plate. Third option, shielding of magnetic lines of force. As aluminium is paramagnetic material, the last option they gave, electromagnetic induction in the aluminium plate giving rise to electromagnetic damping. Electromagnetic induction in the aluminium plate giving rise to electromagnetic damping. Here's the question. So based on the knowledge of our electromagnetic induction lesson, we need to put the answer. So what is the answer for this question? Let us see. So I am going with the fourth option. We studied the concept of eddy currents. According to Lenz's law, the electromagnetic induction takes place in aluminum plate due to which eddy current is developed, which opposes the motion of vibration of the coil. This causes loss in energy, which result in damping of oscillatory motion of the coil. Whenever we keep a metal plate in a varying magnetic field, some eddy currents gets developed around the periphery of the plate. These eddy currents direction is according to the Lenz's law. So due to the development of eddy currents, the motion of the coil is obstructed, because due to the motion of coil only the magnetic flux is linked here. So the magnetic flux linked with the plate is going to change with respect to time, which leads to the development of eddy currents in the plate, and the direction of the eddy currents is such that they opposes the cause that produced it. Hence the motion of the coil, which is responsible for the generation of eddy currents in the metal plate, is getting obstructed. Hence those oscillations are going to decrease their amplitude. Such a motion is called electromagnetic damping. Due to electromagnetic damping, the amplitude of the motion of the coil reduces gradually and finally becomes zero. So oscillations of the coil ceases due to the presence of a metal plate like aluminum plate nearer in the vicinity of the oscillating coil. Hence option D is correct. One more question let us discuss now. This question was asked in JEE Advanced 2010. JEE Advanced 2010. It is also a simple question. A thin flexible wire of length L is connected to two adjacent fixed points and carries a current I in the clockwise direction. In the clockwise direction as shown in the figure. When the system is put in a uniform magnetic field, of strength B going into the plane of the paper . The wire takes a shape of a circle. The tension in the wire is this is the question. Actually, this is the arbitrary shape of the wire and it is carrying a current I. Once you keep it in uniform magnetic field, going into the paper, it gets circular shape. It gets circular shape. You are asked to find the tension in the string of the wire, or tension in the string. String and wire both are same. You are given the length of the wire as L. It is connected to two adjacent fixed point which carries a current I in clockwise direction. So the direction of current is clockwise. Okay, due to the passes of current in clockwise direction, some force gets developed. The force, whatever it is developed, which brings a shape of circle like this. Now the question is, what is the tension in the wire? First option, IBL. Second option, IBL by pi. Third option, IBL by 2 pi. Fourth option, IBL by 4 pi. So these are the options for the given question. Now let us solve this question. This is an important model. The similar kind of question you can observe in various chapters like surface tension. Even in case of mechanics also, we find a similar kind of question. Let us solve the question. If suppose the circular shape of the wire is having radius r. R is the radius of wire. Then length of the wire is equal to 2 pi r. Actually, they provided the length and now it has got a shape of circle of radius r. Then radius of the loop is given by L by 2 pi. This is the first observation of us. Later, if you take a small portion of the wire, this is the small portion of the wire, the tension, it is like this. Actually, it is tangential. It is also tangential. The tension in the string is like this. Okay. And suppose if you take the center O here, and if you take a small element of length DL here, small element of length DL here. So if I draw the radius like this, you will have a component of this tension in this direction. This angle, let me take it as theta. This is also theta. If it is theta, this angle is also theta. This angle is also theta. Then the component of tension here is t cos theta. Here it is t cos theta. So t sin theta will be in the downward direction. Because of this, t sin theta will be there because of this. So 2t sin theta will be in the downward direction. The Fleming force, whenever you keep a current carrying loop in a uniform magnetic field, it experiences a force according to Fleming left hand rule. As per the question, the current, it is flowing like this, field is into the paper, so force is upwards. So the force due to the magnetic field is upwards. The component of tension opposing this force due to magnetic field is given by 2t sin theta. 2t sin theta. Actually, very small element I considered. So theta is very small. So 2 theta is also small. So whenever 2 theta is small, 2t sin theta, when theta is small, sin theta can be taken as theta. So you can write it as 2t into theta, approximately 2t into theta you can write for our convenience. That force due to magnetic field is given by BIL. B is the strength of the magnetic field, I is the strength of the current passing through that, and the element you considered is having length DL. BIDL is the force due to magnetic field. This found force is to be balanced by this 2t sin theta. So BIDL must be equal to 2t into approximately theta. If I take the entire loop into consideration, then DL tends to total length of the loop, then theta tends to 2 pi, then theta tends to 2 pi. Otherwise, if you take this small theta as d theta, this is also as d theta, d theta, d theta, anything you can write, then it is d theta is very small, 2d theta is small, so it becomes 2 sin d theta, 2 sin d theta. When theta is very small, 2t d theta you can write, d theta also you can write. And then you can go for integration, either this way or that way, anyway you will get the same result, integral dl, because b is constant, I is constant, 2t into integral d theta. So bi into, if you join all the elements, you will get the complete length of the loop, then integral d theta is theta, theta is 2 pi for complete loop. Then you are asked to find the tension, so tension is BIL by 4 pi, the tension is BIL by 4 pi. This is the solution for the given question. Last question of the topic. It is an integer type question. Here is a circuit like this. Here is a capacitor of 5 farad capacity attached with one inductor and a resistor. Resistor is having 1 ohm resistance. Inductor is 0.5 henry and the terminals are A, B. This is the question figure given to us. In the circuit shown, Q, where is Q means the charge available on the capacitor. In this circuit, Q where is with the time T as Q is equal to T square minus 4. Find potential difference between the terminals A comma B at time T is equal to, actually Q is in coulombs, at time T is equal to 3 seconds. Answer you require in volts. This is the question given to us. Question is simple. Solution is also simple. This model questions we already discussed. Now, the solution. As per the question, the charge is given as a function of time like this. The current in the circuit is given by dq by dt, that is d by dt of t square minus 4, that is 2t minus derivative of 4 is 0, 2t. At time t is equal to 3 seconds, the current in the circuit, the instantaneous current in the circuit is 2 into 3, 6 amperes. But due to the presence of inductor and resistor, you are asked to find the potential difference between A and B. Let me take the derivative of current also. Di by dt is d by dt of 2t, that is equal to 2. The potential drop at capacitor is given by Q by C, and potential drop across the inductor is minus L into di by dt. Potential drop at the resistor is IR. So potential at A minus Q by C, because you are going from high to low. High to low means negative. Minus L into di by dt minus IR, which is equal to potential at B. You require VA minus VB. VA minus VB is given by Q by C plus L into di by dt plus IR. Q by C plus L into di by dt plus IR. Q value, the charge at t is equal to 3 seconds. From this equation, Q is given by 3 square minus 4, that is 5 coulombs. So 5 by 5, L value they gave it as 0.5, di by dt you calculated it as 2, current value calculated it as 6, resistance value 1 ohm. So it is 1 plus 6, 8 volts. 8 volts is the answer for the given question. Very, very simple. You just check the relationship between Q and T. Then we calculated current as a function of time. Even the current is also varying with time. So variation of current with time is given by that equation. And finally, I applied KVL to calculate the potential difference between A and B. So thank you very much. In the similar way, you try to solve all the questions which are given on the back side of our integrated book. And whenever and wherever you feel difficulty, you just interact with us. Thank you.